In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor that uses two exponential moving averages and the MACD as a filter to create buy and sell signals. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on the IDE button or press F4 on your keyboard. Here we have the pre-coded solution. We start by importing the file Trade.Mqh. This one comes with MQL5 and it provides a few functions for position management. The next two include statements here are for the modules that we use to create the EMA crossover signal and the MACD filter signal. We use normalise double and symbol info double for the current symbol on the chart to calculate the ask price by using symbol underscore ask, and the bid price by using symbol underscore bid, and with normalized double and underscore digits. And underscore digits, we make sure that we can calculate the right number of digits behind the dot. That is a different number depending on the currency pair you use. Now let's create an instance of the class Ctrade that will be called Trade, and we are going to use it to open positions later on. Inside of the Ontick function, we use MQLArrays to create an array for the price data. And with ArraySetAsSeries, we sort our price info array from the current candle downwards. And with copyrates, we fill the price array with price data for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart, starting from candle 0 for 3 candles. And we store the result in our price info array. To calculate the current price, we declare a double variable, and that will get the price info value for candle 0. Actually, we are going to use the close price. And as candle 0 isn't finished so far, the close price is the current price. In the next step, we are going to find out if we have a trading signal by using the function check entry EMA, that's the one in this module. And afterwards, we use a filter signal and check the entry signal for the MACD, that's the one in this module. And if the trading signal equals buy and the filter also equals buy, and we have no open positions, that's when we use trade.buy to buy 10 microlot. In the other case, if the trading signal equals sell and the filter signal also equals sell, and we have no open positions, that's when we use trade.sell to sell 10 microlot. Finally, we use the comment statement to output the trading signal and the filter signal on our chart. That's it for the main module. Now let's check the EMA crossover module. Here we have a function called checkEntryEMA. First, we need to define a string variable for the entry. Then we will create an array for the 20 candles moving average and for the 50 candles moving average. To do that, we use the IMA function for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. We do that for 20 candles or for 50 candles. We don't use a shift value, so we set that to 0. We use mode EMA for the close price, and we repeat the whole thing here for the second moving average. Afterwards, we use array set as series for the moving average array for 20 candles, and we do that again for the moving average array for 50 candles, and with copy buffer, we can fill our moving average array according to the definition that we have created above. The EMA only has one line, and we copy the values from the current candle for 3 candles and store them in the moving average array for 20 candles or below in the moving average array for 50 candles. And if the moving average for 20 candles is currently above the one for 50 candles, and if it was below for candle 1 before, that's when we have a buy signal, and that's when we assign the word buy to our entry signal. In the other case, if the moving average array for 20 candles now is below the moving average array for 50 candles, and if it was above for candle 1, that's the candle before, that's when we have a sell signal, and that's when we assign the word sell to our signal. Finally, we return our entry signal to the main module. That's the one with the Ontick function here. Now let's check out the MACD filter. Here we have a function called checkEntryMACD. We also create a string variable for the signal. Once again, we need two price arrays. And we use the function iMACD for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. These are three standard parameters. You can check them out when you open the MACD on your chart. And we want to use the calculation based on the close price. With array setter series, we are going to sort the array for price array 0 and price array 1. And with copy buffer, we copy the values according to the MACD definition that we have created above, either for the first signal that the MACD creates or for the second one. Because if you look closely, you will see that we have two lines here, a little red one and the gray part. Once again, we copy data from candle 0, that's the current one for 3 candles, and store them either in price array 0 or in price array 1. And now we can calculate the MACD value 0 and the MACD value 1 by looking into candle 0 of our price arrays. Here I have added a print statement, so when you click on the journal tab, you will see the current values here. And if the MACD value 0 is below the MACD value 1, that would be a sell signal, and that's when we assign sell to our signal. Otherwise, if the MACD value 0 is above the MACD value 1, that's when we have a buy signal, and that's when we assign the word buy to our signal. And finally, we return the signal to our main module. So now we are done. We should now get a trading signal and a filter signal. So let's compile the main module. I made a little mistake here. So let's remove the dot, save this one, and recompile the code. And this time it worked. Now let's open MetaTrader, click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Here we pick the standalone EMA MACD expert advisor that we have created. Let's enable the visual mode here and start a test. Here is the strategy tester. We currently have a MACD signal, but no crossover for the EMA. And that changed right away. Here we have a buy signal, and the first buy trade is a profit. Now let's see, it should continue to create signals. This one is a sell signal. Now let's see if, yes, this is also a profit. So our little expert advisor works. And in this little video, you have learned how to create an expert advisor that is able to calculate buy and sell signals based on exponential moving averages and use the MACD signal as a filter. This was an idea from a premium course member, and if you are already a premium course member and have an idea for this one, just let me know. Otherwise, the premium course might be interesting for you, and you can find that one on our website or in the store. If you don't like to do all the coding yourself, we have some offers where you can download the source codes. And that's it for now. Thank you for your attention, and I will see you in the next video.